Very good morning, students. So today I hope that you all are safe and sound in your home and having a great spirit fighting the corona. So today in this online series of notes which we are giving you, so I am giving you the first note on microwave engineering, right? So basically we have covered up till second unit. So the third unit is basically of microwave circuits. Okay, so there are lots of microwave circuits. So basically the most important microwave circuits in our course are three port network and four port network. Okay, so basically this three port network consists of things like circulator, isolator and some T's like E-plane T and H-plane T. We will all discuss these three as we these three port network as we go forward. Now four port network, there are other three port and four port network also. I'm just covering those things which are important for our syllabus. For four port network, the most important thing is magic T and directional couplers. Now here the most important thing which I want to tell you is all these either we say about three port network or four port network, all these things are made up of a very basic thing which we have already studied, is called waveguide. So waveguide, basically rectangular waveguide. Right? So basically what we do is we do some kind of design changes to rectangular waveguide and then we get things like circulator, isolator, E-plane T, H-plane T, right, magic T, directional couplers, etc. Okay, so basically what is a three port network or what is a four port network? So you have already studied this three port thing or four port thing in network, like the electrical network subject which you guys have done, I guess, in third sem or fourth sem. But here the port and network thing is same, but here you have to understand the network we are dealing are microwave networks. All right, so the basic idea of network thing will be the same, but few things will be different here in microwave networks. All right, so first I will explain you what do you mean by three port network or four port network. Then there are so many parameters also to study these networks, as you have already studied in your electrical network part, like Z parameter, right? And then you have already also studied, I guess, Y parameter, and maybe H parameter. Okay, so we will also use these basic parameter here to study microwave networks, but we will also use some other parameters like S parameter, which will give us more insight to the microwave network. Because this Z parameter and Y parameter doesn't give the whole picture of microwave network, so we need an extra parameter which is called S parameter. As you remember, I have already told you, when we are dealing with low frequency, when we are dealing with low frequency, like in electrical low frequency network or low frequency, everything, all the rules are based on Ohm's law or Kirchhoff's law. Right? But here we are dealing with microwave frequency. Okay? So which is a very high frequency. So what happens? Ohm's law doesn't apply here. So Ohm's law doesn't give you the whole picture in high frequency. Okay? Same goes with Kirchhoff's law. Because we don't have the whole network, we don't have current or voltage form. The signal is not in current or voltage form. It is in electromagnetic form. So only at the ports you will have current or voltage. But inside the network you will have electric field, electromagnetic field. So basically you need Maxwell equation, as we have discussed it many times. So you will need Maxwell equation to study the network. Okay, so right now we have covered all these things. Okay, so now I will tell you what is a port. So you have seen a rectangular waveguide. It looks like this, right? It looks like this. So you can give input either at this port or take output at this port, right? Or you can also reverse it and you can give input here and take output from this side, right? So this type of a thing is called a two-port network. Okay, where you have two ports, one is for input and one is for output, and you can use it anyway, like you can give input here or you can give input here, and on the other port you will take the output. So this is called a two-port network. But what happens to a three-port network? In a three-port network, I'm making a two-dimensional diagram this time of a three-port network. So you will have something like this, where you will have 1, 2, and 3. So you will have 3 ports, 1, 2, 3. You can have it anyway. You can also have it like in a circulator. We have these 3 ports in circular thing like this. 1, and then you have 2, and then you have 3. So in circular shape, in circulator we have these ports in circular shape. Same goes with isolator also. You can have port number at any place, 1, 2, and 3. So this is your 3-port network. Now you will say, where we will give our input and where we will give our output. Like here, we can give our input any side and we can take output from the next port. But here we can give input to any one port or any 2 port. Okay? So you can give input either here, and you can also give input to 2 ports, here and here. And then you can take output from the 3rd port. And you can also do this thing as vice versa. You can give input here, 1 input, and then you can take output here and here. 2 outputs. So this is okay. Similarly, you can give input here, and you can give input here, and you can take output from here or here. Similarly, you can give input here, or you can take output from here and here. So it doesn't matter. We'll go in detail later on. So this is your 3-port network, all right? So now if you need 4-port network, so you have to make a 4 ports. Now how can you make a 4-port? You can have it anyway. Just you have to play with the design. So this way also you can have 4-port. You can think like these are 2 waveguides, one over the other, and you have made a hole here so that the ports can interact. So you can have port 1 here, port 2 here, port 3 here, and port 4 here. Otherwise you can also have ports like this. I'm making a 2D diagram of a 3D object. So this way also you can have 4-port network. So this will be port 1, port 2, port 3, and port 4. So it doesn't matter how you make the design. So this network, this type of a network is called 4-port network. Okay, so what we have discussed till now about microwave circuits, or we can say microwave networks, is so basically we have to study 3-port network and 4-port network here, right? So 3-port network, the basic devices which we have to cover are circulator, isolator, E-plane T, H-plane T. This T part you will get in one topic in the book, okay? So T is one topic. So two types of T are 3-port network, and one type of T is magic T. Okay, so as I was telling, so you have to study all these 3-port network, then you have to study 4-port network, these two in 4-port network. And if there will be any other thing in 3-port or 4-port, we will cover that. So for reading all these 3-port and 4-port devices, we will need some parameters, network parameters, which you have already covered few of the parameters in the electrical network thing, like Z parameter and Y parameter. So we'll only use these two parameters. Maybe if we need some more parameters, we will discuss it. But the most important parameter to understand microwave network is S parameter. And why this is very, very important, we will discuss it. Okay, and I was telling you about low frequency we need Ohm's law and Kirchhoff's law, high frequency we need Maxwell equation to understand, right? So this is the introduction of network. I will also send you some notes about it, and if you want to go through yourself and study more about the introduction to network, you can follow this book, Microwave Engineering by Simon Liu. Okay, and you know that we follow this book for our course, and you can also follow this book, Microwave Engineering by Pozar. This is also a very good book for microwave network. Okay, and then there is one more writer, Hindi writer. If you want to follow a Hindi writer, then Microwave Engineering by M. Kulkarni. You can also follow this book. But best is you study from Simon Liu or Pozar if you want to do standard reading according to your course. Okay, so this is it. I'll send you notes about the introduction, and then we can see how we can go forward. All right.